set for life. Look in the mirror, say bitch, I'm the best, 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 best. Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. I want to say this before we get into this video, thank you guys for 199 subscribers. By the time I upload this video, I will be at 200 subscribers hopefully. So let's get into this packaging. I ordered this wig from Unice, the official website. This packaging is really really pretty. I was really really shocked. So when you open the package, it comes with elastic band, a wig cap, and of course, you know, the wig. So the wig that I ordered is a 6/13 14 inch wig. So this is how the wig look out of the packaging. It's very shiny, it's very bouncy, it has volume, all of that good stuff in a wig that a wig needs to have to make it look good. So this is the transparent lace wig, and this is the construction of the wig. It comes with adjustable straps, three combs as usual, the typical wig, you know, every typical wig comes with. So let's get into this video or coloring this hair. So as you guys know, you guys need hot water. You guys could use hot water from the faucet, or you guys could use boiling scorch hot water, but I use hot water from the faucet. And the color that I'm dyeing this wig is Periwinkle. I used 3 bottles of Periwinkle to dye this wig. And before I started dyeing this wig, I was really, really scared. I didn't know what I was doing because this is a color out of my comfort zone. So I went ahead and just said, you know, F it and just dipped the whole wig in there. So I dipped the lace in first before I dipped the ends, because I wanted the, you know, the more color on the lace instead of the end, because in my previous video of me watercoloring my wig, the ends was more darker than the lace. I mean, not the lace, but like the front of the wig. So I continued doing this step, adding the color, mixing, dipping, adding the color, mixing, dipping. And the color of the wig really, really came out really, really pretty. It came out light and dark, you know, both mixed. Right here, the color didn't take too good right here, so I went in with the last bottle that had a little bit more of dyeing it, and I shake it on top of it, and then I just try to mix it in together, but it wasn't working. So I end up just like mixing the water and then dipping the whole wig back in after I add the you know, the rest bit of the dye that was in all of the bottles. I really was trying to get every single drop of this dye, because at first I was like, oh my god, this is a color that I'm not gonna look good in. But then when I first dipped the wig in, I was like, okay, you know, this color, I could pull this color off. So that's exactly what I ended up doing. I just ended up adding the rest dye in the bottles, because I just needed every last bit, because I felt like the wig just wasn't the right color. So I just needed every last bit, a little more, you know, a little more, just to make it the color that I was going really, really going for. Thank you. So right here, you guys, I'm just gonna go in and check the wig, making sure the you know, the wig take all the color, and it really did, and it came really pretty. I'm going to show you guys a clip of the color, and the clip that I'm showing you guys, I had it sitting in conditioner because the conditioner, you know, make the wig very soft and easy and manageable to work with. I'm just gonna go in and show you guys how I pluck my wigs. So the first thing I do is just, you know, part the baby hair out, and then I make sure the baby hair is out of the way because the baby hair is already plucked already. So I just went ahead and part the baby hair out of the way. I want to spray the hair some, and then I just start plucking right behind of that on the hairline where you see it's very thick, and then just pluck where you can see it's getting thin. I'm not a perfectionist, I'm not a professional, I may not know what the hell I'm saying, but I pluck my wig them to my likings, and I pluck them how I like it, and when I see that I can't pluck anymore, I just stop and move on to the next section. But the way how I pluck my wigs, I pluck them in three sections, the side two to the sides, and then the middle take more longer because I feel like it's just more thicker there. But I just pluck my wigs to how I like them. Oh, I also want to say this, when I was dyeing this wig, and when I was, like, you know, washing it with the conditioner, this wig really had zero to minimal shredding. Also, after when I finished pluck this wig was not shredding at all. You know, some wigs normally shed when you pluck it and when you wash it, but this wig right here, it has zero to minimal shredding. So this is a plus in my book for this wig. I would definitely be ordering this wig again, but in a longer length. So that's just what I wanted to throw in here. So this is how this side looked when I finished got done plucking, and it came out really good to my likings. So now this side right here, you guys, this side didn't really need that much plucking. So I went ahead and just, you know, lightly plucked this side because I seen that this side was like really, it just didn't really need that much plucking, because if I would have continued keep plucking, I would have had like a lot of bald spots, and I wasn't having that. So I ain't even installed this wig yet, and I just wasn't having it. So I just went ahead and just parted twice. Well, parted once, and then I just plucked it. because this side really didn't need it that much plucking. So I'm gonna show you guys like right here. Yeah, right here, you see that little ball spot right here. I'm gonna show you guys it. That's the little ball spot for me over plucking. That's what I was talking about. I over plucked. So I went ahead and blow dried my wig off camera using the Fruity Sleek and Shine Anti-Frizz Serum and the Sleek Chic Infusion. And also I'm going to be using this Hold and Flex Fruity Garnier Hold Spray to crimp my hair so that way the crimp can hold and be firm but not too stiff. I don't know if you guys can see it, but I can. So like I was saying earlier in the video, the wig has two tone colors. It is like a darker and like a light color. So that's what I was talking about, as you guys can see right here in the video. I mean, you guys could see it for yourself. It's right here. Like y'all see the little two-tone, is dark and in this light. That's exactly what I was going for, and this is exactly how the wig came out. So after my last crimp, you guys, I go in and spray the Fruities, Garnier Fruities Hold and Flex Spray one last time before I go in and detangle it with the white to comb. So I'm detangling it right here, you guys, and this is exactly how the crimp came out. It came out really, really beautiful and really, really perfect to my liking, to how I like it. But I feel like I should have crimped it a little, leave the crimper on it more longer so that way the crimp could be like more tighter. But this is just the end of the video. Hope you guys like it. Thank you guys for watching. See you in the next one.